In GIMP 2.10, some new color tools have been added. Open Girl Summer. The human eye is very good at removing color casts. Our eyes will compensate for the changes in color temperature so that white objects quickly look white to our eyes, although objectively they are not. A camera isn't always that good at compensating for changes in color temperature, which is why a camera sometimes captures a bit cooler or warmer colors than we perceived it. Color temperature objectively is described in Kelvin and ranges from 1000 Kelvin to 12,000 Kelvin. Higher color temperatures are more bluish, so cooler colors, and lower color temperatures are more orange, so warmer colors. When an image looks a bit too warm or too cold, we can correct this with color temperature. My image is a bit too warm, so I drag the slider a bit to the right. When I click on preview, I see I have a bit more natural skin tone. With split view, you can drag a line to quickly compare the before and after in a specific area. Now open Girl Winter. This image is taken in the winter. The skin looks a bit purplish. However, there isn't an overall color cast. This is why color temperature now won't bring a solution. But with GIMP's new U-chroma filter, I can quickly remove the purple from the skin. By activating split view, I can compare the left and right side of the face. And lastly, let's look at the new and powerful shadow highlights filter. Open Dark Shadow. I open Shadows Highlights. This image has some very dark shadows that are not recoverable with levels or curves. When I drag shadows to the right, the shadows in the image are lightened up. This filter works for some images and for some it won't. For those images it doesn't work, you can use the Shadow Adjustments slider of the Viveza plugin, which is described in the Nik Collection chapter. In the next lecture, we will look at the color picker.